So to attach the collar onto the shirt, place the collar on the inside and the shirt on top. It is left open at the beginning, so now I did pull on the thread just a little bit just to make sure that the collar fits in place. Now once you've tacked it down, what you need to do is finish that edge that we left open at the initial stage and just close that off. Close it off on the other side as well. Open the seam up. Close the neckline glatty off. Push all the excesses towards the inside and we're going to just seam right on the edge of our seaming all the way around. Thank you. just a little bit of cautionary advice here. If you're attempting colors for the first time, then don't be too adventurous and try it on a fancy garment. Preferably try it out on a simple cotton. This fabric is not cotton. I would suggest trying this out on a cotton. And you know what? Despite my brilliance, even the perfector was make mistakes. I should have really attached this on the other side, but oh, you can't tell, but ideally I should have attached it on the other side so that this interfacing side should have come on the top side of the collar. You'd have to excuse me, it's very late at night. I've had a very busy day. My brain isn't working right. That's a petty excuse. I think not having done this for a very long time, I'm quite happy with the result. Although I am a little bit saddened by the fact that I've just gone and done this on the wrong side. And it's not as I wanted, but never mind. It's going to have to do now. There was two reasons why I didn't want the collar attaching on this side. One, because it's quite a thin fabric and you can actually see a narrow line of excess fabric. And secondly, the fabric had actually got stained a little bit and I didn't want to use that side up. But never mind, beggars can't be choosers. I'm going to press this now. There is only one final part to this left, which is going to be the hem. Now the hem is rounded, so there's a couple of things that you can do to do a round hem. I'm just going to do a very very quick one this time. So what we're going to do is we're going to do two turnings. So the first turning, what we're going to do is just a very narrow turning. I'm stitching on the right side and I'm just going to keep folding this over, and I'm going to do this twice. So it's a very narrow fold on the wrong side, turning towards the wrong side. And I'm just going to keep going like this and just turning it over. And then keep it at an angle, keep it at a slant. And the more slant you keep it, the better the result will be. As you can see, I'm just guiding the fabric. So this is one turning, and then we're going to do a second two turning, exactly the same as the way we've done the first one. Now she wanted this shortened, so I've slightly shortened this down for her. And you are going to be watching me make these shirts in probably dozens of colors, because she wants one in every color. So a dozen shirts for a dozen days is what we'll name them. A dozen shirt for a dozen days. How nice is that? You know, sometimes I think of what to name my videos, and then some random name comes in my head and I just name that. And I think by the time I've finished, you'll have video names after people and after members and after days and after months and after years. Okay, so that's one turning. We're going to do the exact same all over again. What that will do is we'll take the first turning and all the raw edges and hide them away. So we're still going to sew on the right hand side. this will only sit once it's pressed. You will have to lift the foot up occasionally just to make the fabric sit better. One of my members from Sri Lanka was on a night mission yesterday, and sewing this shirt reminds me of my night mission. The things we do for our children. Now I saw her photo of her young daughters dressed in those frocks, and they were over the moon. And I suppose, you know, when your children are happy and you've gone and done something for them, then the result is worth it. Okay, pressing time. I'm going to press this and then add the buttons to this. Take away the seam. But I'm going to put the buttons on before I take away this seam, because I'm not going to do buttonholes. I'm just going to put the buttons on and just really just close it off.